big fan of Buffalo Wild Wings in particular, especially on the 50 Cent Wing Night. So we started having this conversation. What's it going to look like? How do things work? As we looked at questions and we tried to find answers, one of the biggest things that we ran into is, well, I don't know. You know, well, this is modern poultry production. How does this work? Well, I don't know. So there was a lot of questions and a lot of interest. So in the spirit of extension and bringing K-State's resources to the world, we said, let's have an educational meeting and let's talk about modern poultry production. So we put our heads together, and Mitch is with a chamber here. He was gracious enough to partner with us and said, hey, we've got a great venue and we'd love to be part of this conversation. Come on in. Welcome. We're glad to have you.
You mentioned the first quarter decision from Tyson.
Well, that's generally that's what we've been told would be sometime the first quarter.
Okay. And so that will consist of an offer to whatever areas they are looking at.
I would think so.
And so is there anything formalized among any of those locations now as far as formal agreements?
No. Not that I'm aware of. It's still all basically they're back to square one on their hunt.
Yeah. That curve going down constantly, and quite frankly, the only time we ever saw that happen was the 09 dip, right, when the economy kind of went off the cliff there. People weren't spending a lot of money. So we saw a little bit of change there. It continues to go up. And there's all kind of forecast numbers out here, and I don't trust any of these now because right now with exports and things, we don't know where that's going to stay. So,
question. Do you have any information about why there's a seemingly steady decline in production of pork? If I'm reading that right.
Of pork?
Yeah.
It's not a steady decline. It's kind of a sideways type deal.
Yeah.
Pork from the United States, it's more subject to the export deal. There's some cultural things on pork around the world. Cost. It's there, but it's not the cheapest. That doesn't help, but it's there. I would say not going down when you see poultry going up like that is a winner. Okay, so right now holding steady, treading right now is probably a good deal. So I don't know if that's going to continue. It'd be interesting to see what happens there. It's probably in the 93-94 percentile. So everything else is all little stuff, amino acids and vitamins and minerals and stuff like that. So corn and soybeans is about everything. In fact, let me start off with the feed mill. That's Kansas State's expertise. The feed mill is a big complex. It's probably going to be most of these things that I see going in. They're built by very specialty construction companies. There's about two or three in America that do them. They're slip form today. They're very expensive. They're between 20 and 25 million bucks a piece. They're highly automated. They'll produce upward, if they put in one line of production, they'll produce 90 to 120 tons per hour of finished pellet feed. So it's a big complex. If you drove by it, you'd know it was a feed mill. It's pretty large, 12, 15 stories, maybe bigger than that. You'd see the parking lot. Other than that, you wouldn't really know it was operating. It's going to operate a lot of hours during the week. It's going to have a steam vent. So we also lost a turkey company who was looking at coming into Kansas, and they moved on to Beatrice. They don't do anything but produce hatching eggs, and they produce offspring. They are then shipped to a company like this as little chicks, which are then put in barns, grown, okay, by the meat producing company. They're grown by the meat producing company, and those are going to be the parents that are going to finally produce the stock you're going to eat. Okay? So a big integrated company would call this little company, okay, and they would buy the parent stock. And when the parent stock, either got worn out or it was time to replace them, they'd either call the same company and ask for more, or they call a different company and say, want to try your stock. So those are completely different complexes there. So I just want to talk about them just a little bit. But in reality, I want to talk about where that feed goes. It's going to go to two spots in here. And these are really important spots because in this entire complex, if you're not going to be part of the complex, this is where, if you're interested in growing birds or growing the product, this is where you participate. I would call both of these contracting opportunities. These are not going to be corporate type relationships, they're going to be contract type relationships. So I'll tell you how that is in just a second. So that's the feed, and this is the way it really kind of works.
119 or say 120 pounds of nitrogen per acre to meet the nitrogen needs of that corn crop. So, you know, opportunity to do some best management practices. You're getting the nitrogen out ahead of the corn, and then come back once that corn is up, able to utilize that nitrogen and apply your commercial nitrogen.
Depending on what substrate you use, you know,